Hey, you're back. How did the mind control drive go?
How did it go?
Here we go.
No!
I don't even know what's breaking.
It was okay.
Good. Did you hit anything?
Hit anything?
Oh yeah, we collided.
Oh no.
Okay, stop.
It is completely broken.
Just some unimportant stuff.
That's good. Was it easy to control the car?
No! Everything is breaking.
No! Stop!
No!
No, stop! Stop! Stop!
Is it even still working?
Yeah, it's still working. Kinda.
You know what bothers me the most?
What?
You're telling this story backwards.
Yeah, well, the ending is more exciting.
But like, how did you get to this point?
Oh, I'm assuming this is like a point in the video where an epic title card comes in and a quick montage of how I got to this point. So, we have the basics of the drivetrain done. As you can see, we have two large Lego motors and we have this differential in here that makes the car turn smoothly. I think this is pretty sturdy, like this is not gonna come apart accidentally. And it's actually decently fast as well. So next up, I would like to work on the steering mechanism so that we have the full drivetrain done. I might have done that classic YouTuber thing where you start doing some stuff off camera and you're not really thinking about it. So like, you kind of just do some stuff and suddenly you blink and like, half the car is done. And I have none of it on footage. Like, I have no footage of it. So this is now just here, a car. And actually, I think we can just build the front off camera as well, and I'll just like put some music under it, do some cuts, and we can do the same for the back. Look. Wow, and now the back is done too. Look, it even opens. That's so cool. But there's actually one more thing I changed. Look, the design of the roof has changed. Look at that. That's looking a lot better, but there's only one side left to do. There, the entire car is done, and I am really happy with how it looks. The thing is though, building the car was never really the problem. The real problem is, how do I control this car using only my brain? Well, I bought this very expensive headset and it's called EEG or electroencephalography. You don't need to remember that, but we should be able to use this to read my mind. All it really does is measure tiny electrical signals from the outside of my head. And in theory, we can use this to control the car on a real racing track later in the video. But here's the problem. I have about 86 billion neurons, and this headset measures them using just 14 sensors from outside my skull. It's like standing outside of a football stadium, trying to understand what the crowd inside is chanting. Everything just blends together and most thoughts look basically the same. And there's a second problem. Delay. I can start thinking something, but it takes about 2 seconds before the signal is clear enough to use. And that's assuming I can even think a specific thought. Because if I want to control a car with this, I can't just think. I need to be very specific. Which means training, like actual hours of practice. So the first thing I did was go live. I got to work putting on the headset for the very first time.
How does this work? So when I'm like active? Wow, look at that, there's a lot of activity. I'm just gonna try training this, mental commands. I guess I'm just gonna have to sit around and just like do nothing. I'm gonna have to lock in.
And then straight to training my first command. Just one to begin with.
Okay, that's something. I imagine pushing, it should move.
And to my surprise, it actually worked.
Did you see it move?
I need to lock in.
So I thought, okay, easy, let's add another one.
This is definitely not gonna work, that didn't feel great.
And that's where it all fell apart.
No, I don't want to lift. Why is it not pushing?
As soon as I added a second command, the software just couldn't really tell them apart anymore. So when I used one command, it worked fine, But two, it might as well have been random. And we don't need two, we need four. So yeah.
So after the stream, I started doing training sessions. I tried imagining movements on the left side of my body versus the right. I tried mental arithmetic, singing songs in my head, repeating rhythms, imagining images. And every time, these dots that were supposed to spread out just stayed right on top of each other, which meant the car would have no idea what I actually meant. Now, I wanted a way to actually see what was going on. So I built myself an interface.
It shows the signal quality, how strong the connection is, what my brain activity looks like, and most importantly, this command space, where everything I'm thinking, all those commands, are visualized. So it shows what the car will actually be doing when I think certain things.
And while I was creating this, I kept training, session after session, just trying new thoughts, looking at the graphs, until slowly I landed on a combination of distinct thoughts, and after hooking up the commands to the car, I was ready for my first test.
I know the lighting isn't great, but you're just gonna have to deal with that, okay? What I'm gonna try is make it drive forward, okay? That's driving forward. Now I'm gonna try making it drive backwards, okay? There it is, okay. That's left, right, okay. And now drive forward. And now drive backwards. No, that's forward, sorry. Is it even still working? Yeah, it's still working, okay.
Now, if you're curious, this is what I'm actually thinking. To go forward, I imagine the car itself driving forward. To turn left, I picture a big swinging pendulum right in front of my eyes. And to turn right, I just get really, really angry. And to go backwards, I do infinite math in my head, so like 3 plus 7 plus 5 minus 2, etc. But that aside,
we have a proof of concept, and the way we have it right now is how you're supposed to make a mind controller. If I stop thinking, the car stops, and we need that because of all the noise and delay. Let me say that again. If I stop thinking, the car stops. For now.
So let's design a track to drive this mind-controlled car on. I felt like I didn't really have enough space in my room to drive around this Lego car, so I went to my friend Dylan Haegens from the YouTube channel Dylan Haegens, and I asked him a very normal question. Hey Dylan, can I borrow your warehouse for a bit?
Yeah, sure. Don't leave the lights on.
Okay.
Hi! I'm working so hard right now.
So I made a track and a cup stack tower, conveniently placed right next to a corner. But also a speed bump made out of loose Lego bricks, and a bridge the car has to drive under and over. And finally, a finish line.
I think this track will be enough to test this car to its limits. And I also found this very comfy chair that will hopefully help me to stay calm. So let's install the mind control device.
I would love to talk you through the race live, but unfortunately, thinking and talking at the same time is a bit too much for my poor brain. So you're gonna have to deal with voiceover me.
I'm ready, mind control device is on, the code is running, so I'm gonna start the timer right now.
Lights out and we're off, heading straight to the first left-hand corner. But is he gonna stop in time? Yes, he does. He swings it wide, but barely makes the first corner. Approaching the cup tower, where he's gonna need absolute focus to not knock over any of the cups. Is he gonna? Look at that, he stops right before the entire tower collapses. Moments from disaster. But this action brought him off the ideal racing line, so he's gonna have to make an adjustment. But will he avoid the fence in the process? He barely misses the fence as he's on to the next sharp corner. Braking late, turns in, and he hits the apex going into the next sector. The visualization of the brain doesn't show the slightest hint of any activity. Actually, scratch that, there it goes, pure exercise. This must be putting some strain on the driver's brain. But we're nearing the next big obstacle, which is the loose Lego speed bump. During testing, the driver found that the car can get stuck if it doesn't carry enough energy. He needs maximum power delivery here, no hesitation allowed, but oh no, he's lacking determination and is now stopped, trying to climb the bump, but it looks like he's gonna give it another go, scrambling to get enough focus to get the car across. Don't stop now, he's finding traction, finally making it over that treacherous bump. Oh, he's taking the cone with him. Why leave it be when you can take it with you? It's really time to get a grip. The car is unsettled, going wide once again. Back on the power, straight over the curb, stopping right before the fence. Backing up as we're nearing the bridge, the single segment with the highest accuracy needed. Now hold on, hold on, wow! Head-on collision with the barrier of the bridge, that's gonna leave a mark. Second attempt, this time making it onto the bridge. Climbing, approaching that upper corner. Will he get the angle just right? It looks like he might be a little short. Yes, he scrapes the inside barrier, completely wrecking the side, but no time to think about it, because we need to think about those last two corners. First one going smooth, with the finish line getting in sight. Look at that shot of the driver and his car. Don't mess up now, all we need is to cross that finish line. Lining up to cross the line, what a lap, absolutely sensational.
That's fast, right? Come on, a little bit further.
Yeah, that's it.
We did it, a full lap, mind control, I can't believe it. We did hit a few things, but that's just minor damage, okay? But we can do better.
As you may have noticed, I was a bit careful and the car stopped when I lost focus. But what if the car didn't stop? So let's flip it upside down. Instead of holding the thought drive, let's trigger the car to drive. So I think start driving once, and then it just keeps going. To steer, I have to hold the thought left or right. But if I hesitate or lose focus, the car does not wait for me. And because EEG has delay, I have to think ahead. There is not a single safety feature left. And I call it Chaos Mode. Cool name, right? Here we go. No, stop. Go back. Go back. Come on, drive. A little bit left. A little bit left. Left, 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 left. Okay, no. Come on, stop. I'm gonna try to do the entire track. Okay, okay, stop, stop. So, at this point, the car is actively ripping up its inner gears, and from this point on, the car will never be the same.
Oh, that was not a nice sound. Okay, we can still fix this, we can still fix this, come on.
Oh, those gear sounds.
I am so scared to let it drive. I'm gonna put it down. I'm gonna get back in my chair. Get back in my chair. I'm gonna do this. Okay, little bit back. Oh no. I am so scared to let it drive. We can do this. We can finish this track, I believe. I feel like everything's breaking, but I'm gonna put it back. We're gonna keep driving, and we're gonna finish this course. Very slowly, but yes, it's getting up the ramp. And getting down the ramp. Something breaking again. It is completely broken. No, that's... I'm gonna try it again. Okay. Stop. I mean...
Now, if you think you can do it better than, well, this, you can actually try 1 week from when this video is online. As I coded this car so you can drive it around by just typing in a live chat. And 1 week from this video, I will be live at this track and you can drive this car around. So make sure to subscribe for that, or if you just want to see other cool stuff. Thank you for watching.